Hi, fellow Malaysians. We're in extraordinary times, and there needs to be extraordinary economic actions. The government will have to think through the following five issues. First, we must increase spending on healthcare. We are not out of the woods yet. The crisis will continue, and we must escalate. We must search capacity for ICU. We must search hospital capacity. And in the long run, the public will demand more spending on healthcare, particularly because we are aging quite soon as well. Of course, all spending must be transparent. Secondly, there's a need to increase deficit. This is wartime, and the government will have to go to parliament, seek bipartisan support for increasing spending and increasing deficit spending. If the government is thinking to keep to the peacetime deficit ratio, it will never be able to help industry. It will never be able to help Malaysian ordinary people beyond the money given in April and May. So we need to do more. But in order to do more, the government will have to seek bipartisan support, go to parliament, and raise deficit spending. Number three, Bank Negara will have to do more. Bank Negara may have to create helicopter money, creating money in order to help the people. One of the things that Bank Negara can do is to instruct the banks not to charge interest for the next 6 months during the moratorium period. That will be really helping industries, families, and everyone. After all, the banks give loan in the first place, and they must share risk. Risk must not be bound by the borrower themselves. The banks has a responsibility as well. Number four, we must focus on helping Malaysian workers. We must make sure that foreign workers get food and supply until it is safe for them to go home. But in this period of time, all we should do is to ensure that jobs are available for Malaysians. Number five, we must tell GLC and GLICs that their focus is to do social goods in order to save the nation, save the economy. Very often, the GLC think of themselves like a private entity making profit. For instance, hospital. Most of the private hospital in this country are owned by GLC one way or the other. They have 70% of medical resources but treating 30% patients. This is the time to change it. GLC have to do what private sector is not doing. GLC has to invest in medical supply. GLC has to invest in R&D. And they must not do it out of profit consideration. They must do it for social goods. GLIC, such as EPF, must now invest in Malaysia and not thinking of investing overseas. At the moment, 30% of EPF funds are invested overseas for higher yield. But this is the time to invest in Malaysia, invest in critical sector that can deliver social goods. And these are the issues that I hope Malaysians will demand the government to do. And the government will also do it because these are the right thing to do in extraordinary times.